Hello everybody, Dokonasets here. Today we are back with another Dragon Ball figure unboxing video. I know it has been a little while. I think I'm actually going to make a community post regarding the updates and next steps for this channel. So definitely keep an eye out for that. But I'm very excited to hop back into it for today. And what a fantastic figure to look at for the first figure of the year that we unbox. None other than the Dragon Ball Super Superhero Cape and Glasses Gohan. Obviously from the film Dragon Ball Super Superhero. This is a Ichiban Kuji figure that I have been wanting to get my hands on for a fat minute now. And if you are aware, you would probably know that unfortunately, this guy has kind of costed a bit of a pretty penny for a bit of a minute now. And the reason why I decided to pick this guy up now was because I actually got a Amazon gift card for Christmas. Shout out to one of my family members. Appreciate ya. And with that being said, the figure, funnily enough, it was ironic because it wasn't actually on sale from Amazon themselves. It was on sale from a third-party seller on Amazon, but on Amazon, the figure was on sale for about $37. So, with that being said, right, that is probably just about the closest to the actual price that these Ichiban Kuji figures should be, which is of course around that $35 mark, because obviously Bandai has been, upcharging them for some time now. And so since I saw it on sale and I was like, yeah, I probably am not gonna get a better deal than that, I was like, well, time to cop. And not to mention, obviously, being as big of a superhero fan as I am, this was a figure that I was really interested in. Not only that, but this is also just one of my favorite looks for Gohan. Obviously, I have the SH Figure Arts version of this guy, which we took a look at him in a video a little while ago. He was in, I don't remember if it was in the Gamma 1 or the Gamma 2 box, but regardless though, we looked at both of them in the same video. So in that video, we took a look at that. And not to mention, I actually like this look. This is really struggling to get open, by the way. Oh, I see. It's also taped here. Okay. Not to mention, I also love this look for the character so much that I've even cosplayed this before. And yeah, it was pretty fun, honestly. Having those big shoulders was hard walking around the booths at the con, though. Regardless, though, because I love this form so much, I decided to pick up this figure. And not to mention, in terms of building the superhero collection, which, honestly, at this point, that is really the main thing that I'm lacking is superhero figures. I have plenty of Z, which probably still could use a little bit of filling out. I have plenty of Dragon Ball Super by this point, and I definitely have enough Dragon Ball Super Broly. I think I have enough Gogeta figures to make a small army, honestly. All right, let's go ahead and get the boy out of the box here. I actually don't know what I'm pulling at, so I'm just gonna pull and hope for the best. There we go. Let me also angle the camera down a little bit so this is easier for you guys to see, because I had it up so high before, because obviously since the box is so big, I wanted everything to be able to be shown. Not to mention, this guy's actually, oh, he's poking through there. Not to mention, this guy is a lot bigger than I thought he was gonna be. We're gonna have to see when obviously the actual figure is out of the box, but when the box came, I was like, wait, that's way too big. Ooh, okay. So he's actually all in one piece, which I'm kind of surprised about, all things considered, because usually when it comes to figures like this, they come in the multiple pieces. So by the way, I apologize for bumping my camera. Not only am I a little rusty on my figure unboxing shenanigans here, but this guy is also, because the box is so big, I had to move the camera out a little bit. But he does fit in frame, and actually there's only two parts technically to this. We have the stand right here, which let me put this down before I open up the stand, because I don't want to like just, you know, open the stand part and then, just kind of ruin the whole thing. We're going to use this hole, by the way. I do feel the cape is a little loose. We're going to take a look at all that. once we obviously get the figure open. But let's go ahead. We can set him down by the head because he has the bubble wrap on his head, which is nice because a lot of the time they do that for figures where when it's really spiky hair, they'll give him some bubble wrap. Sometimes they don't, but all right, there we go. Bada bing, bada boom. The boy is free. Obviously, this too is not only just because of the spiky hair. Oh, he stands just fine without the stand. Wow, okay. I was kind of expecting a little bit of like shaking there, right? Like, ooh, sorry, I see my camera is not at all centered. Hold on. There we go. That's a little better. Yeah, usually these figures kind of wobble a little bit if they don't have the stand, but my boy will give a little shake test. Okay, I guess he's a little wobbly if you shake the table. So let's go ahead and put the actual base on, which, by the way, is quite literally just this clear piece that is like, you know, your basic Ichiban Kuji clear piece. I'm not sure which foot it goes on. So let's just go ahead and, you know, try and put it on. Okay, well, that was a lot easier than I thought it was going to be honest. Yeah, just slips on like a glove. Shake test. Oh, yeah, that's a lot better. All right. Let's get the boy revealed. Now, obviously, not only is the reason why they have this here because of the hair, but also because of the glasses. Of course, because this is Gohan in the beginning of the movie, right? Right when, you know, he gets the gi from Piccolo. Ooh, hoo-hoo-hoo-wee! That looks so good. Fantastic job with this guy. Let's look at him up close. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I actually do see a couple little blemishes on mine. Let me pull him in real close here. Hello, Gohan. How are you doing, bro? Oh my gosh. Okay, so before I say anything, right, I think the most obvious thing about this figure that is so incredibly good is the face sculpt. I don't think there is any denying that they absolutely cooked on the face. That looks exactly like Gohan to a T. Like, I think you would be hard pressed to get that not looking like Gohan from some angle or something. And what's crazy too is I feel like looking at it on the box, it looks good, right? Like, if we move him over real quick, he looks good on the box in terms of his face. But I feel like the figure looks even better, which is honestly a rarity when it comes to Ichiban Kuji figures lately. And Bam Presto for that matter, because obviously Bandai's a little stinky these days. But wow, I am honestly pretty shocked at how good this guy's face sculpt turned out. Now, I will say the only thing, if I could nitpick a little bit, and it's nothing about the face, which is ironically enough, it's the glasses. I really like the glasses, and I think they do a good job. You can't take them off, by the way, and I'm not going to try because I don't want to break the figure. They are a little bit loose, but like, I'm not going to, you know, try and rip them off and then break the figure. I mean, if you look, right, if we go to the side of the head, you can see they're pretty embedded in there, right? Like, it's pretty easy to see that those boys are not coming out. I don't think Gohan's glasses were this thick in the movie. I mean, if you want to do a side-by-side comparison editing, Theo, you can throw up a picture there. But in the film, I do not remember the glasses being this thick. And I will say that is the one thing about this figure that is kind of a little bit of, oh man, is that because they are so thick, it's a little bit harder to see the face sculpt. They almost kind of look more like goggles, if I'm being honest, where it's like, you know, they just don't have the glass in them. But with that being said, the glasses themselves do still look good, despite obviously being a little bit thick. Gohan's hair is also sculpted fantastically, right? Obviously, he has a little bit more of this kind of rough, you know, scruffy hair look, which, you know, I think works really well on this figure, and they did a good job of capturing. The shoulder pads are fantastically done, right? I really like how they're sculpted. The fabric looks nice, how it should be setting, everything like that. Unfortunately, I don't know if you can see it on camera, but right there and right there, there's actually two little orange spots. Let me get that a little bit closer to the camera for you. Yeah, you can see it right there. It is a little bit hard to see because it's going to be hard to focus on it, but yeah. Two little orange spots on him. I'm not sure why that's the case, though. It's a little bit unfortunate. I could definitely paint that over myself if I really want to, but like, when you're looking at the figure from here, you're really not gonna notice. So, you know, it is unfortunate, but as to be expected with Bandai. When it comes to the cape itself, though, I think that the cape is really well done. If we move to the back of the figure, and I'll just lift it up for you here, the way that the cape flows is immaculate. If we go all the way up here, right? And we look at this guy from the side, it's nice and wide, right? The actual fabric looks like it's flowing down in a natural way, right? The actual like colors and the shadows and obviously the shading throughout the sculpt looks fantastic. I think they did a great job with the cape aspect of this. And interestingly enough, if we turn it around, right? You can see that the inside is actually shaded a little bit blue there, right? Now, with that being said, it is kind of interesting that they decided to shade it blue. I think it's just because in some shots and in some interpretations of the cape, I've seen that. It's also just kind of a way to have like a shadow where obviously, you know, it's kind of inside the shadow of the shoulder pads and Gohan's body and everything, right? So I don't dislike it being blue. I actually think it's a nice little touch. And I mean, I like the color blue, so it's not a big deal for me. But it is interesting they didn't just leave it white. It's weird because usually Bandai's kind of lazy, so it's nice to see some detail on the figure. And Gohan's legs do look nice as well. There isn't really much to write home on the sculpt about this. They just look like Gohan legs, but they do the job. The feet also look very good with the Namekian sixes that my boy is rocking. And, of course, the body is to be expected to be pretty good, along with the arms as well, because obviously with this figure is basically just a re-sculpt of the first two Gohans that we had from Super Hero, right? The Super Saiyan version and the Ultimate version. Now, I do not have the Super Saiyan version nor the Ultimate version. I will definitely not be getting the Super Saiyan version because I'm not a big fan of the face on it. And the Ultimate version, I mean, it's okay. I feel like the hair looks a little weird. Like, it's not like out enough. It's not like puffy or something like that. It kind of like comes up to a point where I feel like that's not really how the Ultimate hair looks. It's not like a terrible figure or anything. And if it was on sale, I would maybe get it sometime. But for my money, I think that this is the best out of the three. And not to mention, this is definitely my favorite look for the character out of these sculpts. I mean, I guess besides Gohan Beast, but I don't know if that one really counts. Anyway, let's go ahead and do some size comparisons on this guy. Getting our usual suspects, because they have not been off the shelf in a minute, they are a little bit dusty, so please excuse any dust that you may see on these bad boys. But as you can see, with this being a Ichiban Kuji figure, right, it is definitely not small by any stretch of the imagination. This is a Masterlize figure. It's not a Masterlize extra figure, but this is usually the size of the Masterlize line from the Ichiban Kuji figures. And if we bring out the good old ruler, this guy stands at about, I'd say, 10.5 inches. That's what it looks like with the angle on camera as well. Maybe more like 10.75. Which is definitely not a bad size, right? He's not a foot tall, but he's definitely not small by any stretch of the imagination either. Okay, so we only have a couple of comparisons for this guy because unfortunately, like I said, I don't have that many superhero figures, but I figured, haha, funny pun. For one, this is gonna be a quick one, but I mean like, dude, how could I not bring this guy out for comparison? Of course, we have the, he's kind of leaning back a little bit, but that's because of the pose that I had him in on the shelf. We have the SH Figuarts Ultimate Gohan. Of course, this guy having the cloak on, as well as the same arm pose, because that's just the pose I had him on the shelf. And of course, the head that came with the cloak to specifically replicate this scene. Obviously, this is the SH Figuarts version with some accessories attached, and it is kind of interesting just to see the minor differences. Obviously, of course, bear in mind that the SH Figuarts version has some points of articulation, so of course, that's why certain aspects of the figure look like that. But in terms of different sculpting detail, it's interesting to see with the SH Figuarts one, the little bit of the different way that the hair is kind of set on the figure. It almost looks like on the Kuji one that his hair is kind of blowing in the wind a little bit. It almost looks a little bit more frizzled out, which I actually think I might like a little bit better because it's almost like the SH Figuarts one, the hair is almost beginning to form into the Ultimate look. And I actually think I like the way that the shoulder pads sit on his shoulders better on the Kuji one, because on the SH Figure Arts one, it kind of looks like they're spiking up a little bit, whereas it looks a little bit more natural, like they're rounded off on the Kuji one. Though I do kind of wish on both of these, actually, the shoulder pads were a little bit bigger. I know they're not incredibly bigger in the movie, but I do kind of wish they were a tad bigger. I think both of the capes are good, and I do like, honestly, how big the cape is on the Kuji one. And of course, because it is a sculpted figure, you know, you do have a little bit of that more dynamic look to it. Whereas, obviously, for the SH figure, it's one that's just kind of a hunk of plastic attached to his back. Or it is sculpted, of course, but, you know, I think that the Kuji one, they were kind of having a little bit more fun with the way that the cape looked. All right, so in terms of our final figures here, I do have these boys. I actually have to give them a little... These two have been on the shelf for a fat minute as well, but these are the only other superhero Ichiban Kuji figures that I own. And that, of course, is the Ichiban Kuji Gamma 1 and Gamma 2. I actually got these guys imported when they originally came out, because the only other Gamma figures that we have are the SH Figure Arts ones and the DXF ones, at least to my knowledge. I don't think there's any other ones. I hope we get some more. Now that I'm saying that out loud, it's kind of crazy we don't have that many. But these guys actually pair really well with Gohan. I'm not gonna lie. I kind of expected them to be a little bit more like different in size, but I actually think the size is pretty good. I don't remember if in the movie the androids were taller than Gohan or not. I feel like they were at the same size, or maybe Gohan was a little bit taller than them. I can't seem to recall. But definitely having these three next to each other, I don't think by any means that they are a bad scale with each other. It's kind of funny because the Gammas in these figures are so long and lanky, and Gohan is definitely a little bit more bulky, but he is a little bit shorter than them. Obviously, his hair kind of compensates a little bit for the height, but the boys do have the fins on their heads, so of course that gives them the edge when it comes to the height on these figures. But wow, these guys look awesome, dude. Oh my gosh. Seeing stuff like this just makes me want to get more superhero figures, because it's like, dude, just look how cool this looks. Oh my gosh. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really, really appreciate it. Definitely go check out this figure if you want to get him for yourself. If you're a fan of superhero or just Gohan in general, I think that this is a figure I can easily recommend. With a lot of modern Ichiban Kuji figures, I feel like I can't say that, but I'm even more impressed with this guy than I am when I saw him in the original images, because I still thought that he looked good then, but even looking at him now, I feel like he looks even better in person, which is awesome, because whenever I can say that about a figure, they did a good job with it. So if you would like to pick this guy up, of course, I will leave some links in the description where you can do so, and if he is available on Amazon still and you do cop him from there, I do get a little bit of an extra cut with no extra cost to you. So thank you guys for your support on that, and I hope you enjoyed the video. I will catch you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Expect more videos soon. Dokkan Assets out. Peace.